What's up,
YouTube? All right, bitches. Paul TV, episode 3 of these podcasts we got coming for you guys. Today we are here with, as always, Big B and Lil D. Your host, A Paul, on A Paul TV. Today we have a special guest as well. It's Andy Punani. Andy gets Punani on his PlayStation.
Gamer and tag.
Yeah, you want to say hi, Andy? Unmute your mic. Just say, I don't know. Introduce yourself. All right. Shut the fuck up.
What's up, YouTube?
All right, bitches. All right. Okay, so this week we got Champions League as well. This week, the rest of the teams for Champions League play this week. On Tuesday, we have
Lazio.
We have Lazio versus Bayern Munich, and we have Atletico Madrid versus Chelsea. What are your thoughts on Lazio versus Bayern Munich?
Bayern Munich, they're the current champions, and they're doing, I think they're first in the Bundesliga by 2 points ahead of Leipzig. They lost this weekend. Lost yesterday, I think it was 2-1. So, I mean, the loss doesn't mean much. They're still first. And in Champions League, they're always strong. They're always a hard team to face. The power just behind the name scares most rivals. And Lazio, they're not doing that great in the Serie A. I think they're like 6th or 7th. And when Ciro Immobile and Luis Alberto don't show up, the Lazio lacks offense. So I'm pretty sure Bayern Munich won't have much trouble getting past Lazio. I'm pretty sure Bayern can get at least a draw in the visit to Italy.
Yeah, like I said, these matches are Champions League, like any European competition, is always like unpredictable because you really don't know what to expect sometimes. But, yeah, I mean, like, Bayern Munich, especially the form they've had these past, like, the past season. And it should be an easy match for them. Lazio hasn't been doing that great in Serie A either, especially this season. Last season, they were pretty good. They were fighting for the top positions almost throughout the whole season. But this season, Ciro Immobile, I don't think, has been showing up. So I think that's one of the reasons why they haven't been doing as great this season.
How old is he?
I think he's like 29, 30 years old.
Yeah, probably 30.
I think he's like 30 already. 31. Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. I'm definitely going with Bayern Munich on this one. That seems logical, but you never know. I mean, what are your thoughts, Lil D?
I think the main consensus would be that Bayern Munich won't lose. Usually they're a solid team. It's a team that has very few weaknesses. So, Lazio will have a hard time figuring them out, I think.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I mean, Lazio, if they want to actually do something, I think they have to play like really defensively both matches because...
Like on the counterattack?
Yeah, mostly counterattack because if you really try to...
It's because Bayern also has speed and
they really have to cover like the left wing and the right wing.
Yeah.
If they have Sané and Abde at the same time, they're going to have a really hard time.
And they have Coman too if one of them isn't playing. So that's definitely a hard match for Lazio. So I guess we could all agree for Bayern Munich on that one. I mean,
yeah, and Lewandowski is on fire like these recent years, so it's gonna be really hard to let him score.
The reigning champions right now.
Yep.
Definitely.
I think everybody on Bayern is just monstrous. Like their physical form is just on point, and I think that has to do a lot with their coaches, their nutrition and fitness, all that. So I think it's hard for anybody to really compete with them physically.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, Bayern Munich is just they're an actual team. Mm-hmm. It's not just or two players. Like pretty good almost all around.
It's their whole philosophy. I think they have a complete everything about them is solid. Everything.
It just seems that Bayern is gonna take it, unless something weird happens, like how Liverpool lost to Liverpool beat Leipzig.
Bayern Munich lost yesterday.
Yeah. It was either yesterday or today. I think it was yesterday.
Yeah, it was yesterday.
I think 2-1.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure they're gonna take it unless something weird happens.
Then again, I mean, to be honest, I'm not sure if Bayern Munich is gonna make it to the final or win this Champions League. But I mean, Lazio, they should get through Lazio.
Who do you think is their main competition? If they were to face who should they fear?
I feel like pretty much everyone else besides Borussia Mönchengladbach.
Mönchengladbach.
Mönchengladbach. Yeah, it is. That's it.
Besides them, I think everyone else is pretty strong. I mean, Atletico Madrid, they play defensively.
That's if Atletico Madrid makes
obviously.
It.
Obviously, Chelsea, they're doing better. Manchester City is really good right now. Barcelona's already basically out. PSG. Yeah, I think everyone right now, after this round, it's gonna be pretty tight.
Weaker teams are getting eliminated this round.
Yeah, definitely. So. All right, moving on to Atletico Madrid and Chelsea. That's a pretty close match, but I'm gonna stick with Chelsea on this one because I think Chelsea's been playing a lot better these recent games, and I feel like they have a pretty strong chance if they really play this two matches the right way. I don't know what you guys think about this one.
Yeah, since Thomas Tuchel got there, they've been improved their game. They have the ball more. They attack more. And Chelsea's just like I said, they improved their game, and they haven't lost yet since they appointed him as the manager. They tied just recently to Southampton 1-1. And Atletico Madrid comes from a 2-0 loss at home to Levante. So, I mean, if Chelsea plays right, I'm pretty sure they can take a win from Madrid.
Oh damn! Yeah, that I don't know about that, but. I mean, they could do it, but I don't know.
Yeah, where are they playing?
They play Madrid. First. They play in Madrid first.
Mm. Yeah, I thought they go made a second.
Yeah.
Madrid first. I could see Madrid holding off a tie in the first leg, and then probably Chelsea taking it.
Yeah. I mean, all the Spanish teams are doing crap. I mean... We're going to get to Real Madrid in a minute for Champions League.
I think if Atletico has is that Luis Suarez probably wants it as to go out on a high for his for his career and stuff.
Yeah, I feel like Atletico Madrid, if you really play really offensively against them, they basically don't do anything anymore because
they don't have speed. They don't have that depth of attack.
No, you don't.
Nah, that's always been Simeone's game.
And their midfield as well is really defensive. They're not players where they'll go out and attack and put crazy ass passes or make plays out of nowhere. You know, so they're more of a defensive team.
They don't even really pressure that high, do they?
Not that much. They wait. They wait for you, and then they go out. So I don't know. I mean, that's a pretty tight match. I think we're all on the same page on that one with Chelsea, but. Who knows? These are really pretty tight matches here. Mm-hmm. And then on Wednesday, we have Atalanta versus Real Madrid. And we have, of course, Manchester City versus Borussia. I'm going to start with Atalanta-Real Madrid. I think that's a pretty close match as well. Because, Atalanta hasn't been playing that bad. They won today 4-2.
Yeah, they won 4-2.
Against Napoli. Yeah, so they're not doing that bad. They're not doing that bad. And Real Madrid isn't doing that great. So... It should be a pretty close match as well. To be honest, I don't know who I'm going to go with on this one. This match is pretty hard to call, but
yeah. And this match, I'm going to say that Atalanta wins this match. I have to see what happens in this match to see if Atalanta will make it through or Real Madrid might be able to pull the comeback or if Real Madrid wins tomorrow. Wins on Wednesday, they just have an easy walk through in the Bernabeu, but I have a strong feeling that Atalanta will beat them in Italy. Yeah, they've been a pretty strong team. It's
possible that Atalanta even beats them in Madrid, I feel.
Yeah, it's possible because Real Madrid lost in group stage. They lost both their games to Shakhtar. That's not a pretty strong
Shakhtar,
team.
Shakhtar, yeah. So, but then again, that's the beginning of the season. Teams are starting to, especially with winter transfer and, you know, just with.
But Real Madrid hasn't really improved
for Champions League, not too much, but.
Haven't really improved their game since the beginning of the season. They're kind of the same.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, Real Madrid and Barcelona as well, I don't know. They can't find their style of playing anymore. Like, they just do whatever comes to mind in that moment. Like, they don't.
Yeah,
it's because I think all their decisions were made by money. They were just money chasing, and they let their academies, their main source of players go dry.
Especially the past 5 to 6 years, like Barcelona and Real Madrid were the teams to talk about in the Champions League. They're the ones that are always like in semifinals and finals. So, and now they're like, they're the underdogs.
Before no one wanted to play against them. Now if they get them, they're like, all right, we could do this.
It's doable, yeah.
Yeah, it's a doable match. Definitely. And I don't know. That's it for this week on Champions League. I don't know. I think we should talk about last week, last week's matches. The week that just passed.
You forgot one match.
One match? What match?
Yeah, the most important one.
Oh, shit, City? Oh, shit.
I mean, you don't really have to talk about it. It's pretty obvious.
Oh, shit, yes. I mean, City, yeah.
I mean, looking at the form, City has 18 consecutive wins right now in all competitions. They have 13 in Premier League. And Borussia just lost home against the second-to-last place team in the Bundesliga. So, to Mainz.
I mean, yeah, City's playing phenomenal. I mean,
it's going to be really surprising if they don't take a win.
Even if they don't play good, they still win. Today, they didn't play that great. They won.
Yeah, but Arsenal didn't play good either. Both teams didn't play good.
No, of course not.
The one that won was the only one that made the goal. That made actually shot on target. Yeah.
If City doesn't do well, I think it'll be probably on the coach because they're solid players. They're players that show up.
Yeah.
Most games.
He's definitely going to play with a number 9. He has to play with a fucking forward in this match. There's no way he cannot go with the same, like,
that's true.
False 9 trying to sometimes Sterling, sometimes Foden. Well, Foden didn't even play today, so.
It's hard to depend on Jesus, though. Cause
I think that Ederson, Cancelo, Stones, Diaz, Zinchenko, Rodri, Gundogan, De Bruyne, Sterling, Jesus.
Foden.
Or instead of Foden, it could be Bernardo Silva.
You going to sub in Agüero or what?
Yeah, he could sub in Agüero. And if he's not 100% fit, he shouldn't be playing. He's just going to get injured again. And
he was on the bench today, right?
Yeah, he was on the bench, but he ain't going. Mm-hmm. And maybe he was actually saving him for...
Maybe.
That's very possible.
To give him at least minutes. Maybe not start, but at least minutes.
I think you give Agüero 15 minutes, there's a good chance he'll score you a goal. There's a very decent chance, I think.
Yeah, especially the way they're playing now. City, the whole midfield is them.
Like to have Agüero as an option for a substitution is excellent. Like it's probably
because the bench today was ridiculous. Like they had Agüero, Jesus, Foden. They had one more player. I forgot. Was Rodri. Like, it was ridiculous. Like if something was going wrong, they could have changed anybody.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. All right, my bad. I almost forgot about City. If Big B didn't tell me, but yeah, it's obvious we're all going for City. What about you, Andy? What do you think about City versus Borussia? Who do you think is gonna take that one?
Who the fuck is Borussia?
Just some German team.
I want to be in the podcast. I'm like, nigga, you don't know shit about soccer. Yeah, I do. Who the fuck is Borussia? It could have been Borussia Dortmund. He's like, who the fuck's Borussia?
City's gonna take the
belt. All right, good. All right. Andy also agrees with us. All right, as I was saying before, I miss City. I think we should talk about the matches that just passed this week in Champions League. We talked about Barcelona PSG. We said that Barcelona could take it because we know how PSG plays. But we did not count on Piqué fucking starting.
Yeah, I was saying that. Like, Ever since they Piqué got injured, their form has improved incredibly. He plays. He comes back. The first game he comes back, he plays against PSG. They score four on him. Four on him. He goes again to pull the damn shirt of a guy, and he does it again.
That's disgraceful, though. For that to happen to you not once but multiple times. That's a disgrace.
Yeah, that just shows like you're not doing. Like you can't even foul the guy. Mm-hmm. You can't even foul him.
You have to pull his shirt, bro.
The biggest problem is why does Coman play him? I mean, I know why he pays him because he has to.
All right, no, he's forced to. Yeah, here's the thing. I understand. Okay, maybe I would play Piqué, but he's coming back from an injury. Why the fuck would I start him out of nowhere?
I'll give you the reason why he has to start him. He has to start him because of fucking Piqué. He has to start him because of fucking Piqué's dad. Because they fucking influenced the damn coach. Like, you better put my son. And, like, he sucks. He's always been average defender, in my opinion. Bang average.
He said it himself. If he has to take a step to the side, he'll do it. Because he loves the team and he wants Barcelona to do good.
It's been years of people telling him that he's great. Telling him that he's the best. People consider him one of the best defenders in the world.
Here's the thing. When Barcelona did the sextete, when Barcelona was freaking really good, they didn't even need fucking defenders. Why? Because they would defend with the ball.
Yeah, they.
They had the ball all the time. They didn't have to defend. They had the ball all the fucking time. The
midfield would get the ball back really fast. Busquets, Xavi, and Iniesta would get the ball back right away.
Yeah, they didn't need really because they would literally defend with the ball. That was their defense. Mm-hmm. Defend with the ball. Pass.
It's like how City does now. Like City gets the ball back really fast.
And there it is again, Guardiola. Yeah. So, I mean.
That's why, I don't know why, like, obviously that's the reason he puts him, but it's annoying. Like, he said that. Obviously, one thing is just
puro fuck. It.
Yeah, he's just fucking talk, but no fucking actually doing it. Like,
Bartomeu did it.
Yeah, own up to your fucking word. If you said it, just get the hell out of there.
Yeah, Bartomeu left.
Leave.
Yeah, but and still, like with this result 4-1, I don't know, man.
But did you see that Piqué was trying to blame other players?
Like he was trying to Griezmann. He was mad at Griezmann.
Yeah. Griezmann sucks.
Barcelona's worst players were arguing.
Yeah, they were blaming each other for.
And then he puts Dest. He puts Dest to the right.
That's the worst soccer player I've ever seen in my life.
Which is that idiot from the United States, which sucks. Like.
So.
He wasn't playing either before the Champions League match. He wasn't playing. Like, he was putting the Mingueza guy.
Mingueza, yeah.
He was putting him in. I don't know where he put Dest. I'm like, I was really confused by the formation of Barcelona, to be honest.
And they started off winning the worst part with the penalty.
Yeah, it was a penalty, though.
Oh, yeah. At first, it didn't seem like it.
It didn't seem like it, but he clipped him. Like.
He did get him. But, I mean, I don't know. And then, everybody talking about, like, how Mbappe is so great, how he's so good. And then he played today and he lost against freaking Monaco.
I think he's a very good player, though.
Yes, he is a good player, but...
Very good. Like.
Nah, but they were comparing him to, like...
He's not a great...
They were comparing him to Ronaldo and Messi. And like,
he shouldn't be compared to them.
No, hell no.
Not at all. But he's a very good
player. Yes,
he could be compared to Ronaldo, but not to Messi.
That's true, yeah. Good point.
Yeah, Look who he's up against. Piqué, Lenglet.
Dest.
Come on.
Those three, because he goes through that side.
Yeah, he goes.
He doesn't go through the Jordi Alba side.
Like, how? No. Wait until he gets to quarterfinal, semifinal, final. If he plays good against those teams, all right.
Against a 35, 36-year-old maybe, Busquets. That's another one.
Yeah, like, Busquets old, man.
That's why. Like, he's not as fast as he
used to be. Numbers are impressive, though. If you look at his numbers in Champions League, even how many goals, I don't even know how many goals he has in a few games.
Oh, Mbappe.
Yeah,
he scores a lot, but then again, he's the final last year. He didn't do shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Neymar didn't do shit either.
Nah, they choked.
Yeah, but against teams where their
so
defense
we
were
got
ass.
That one wrong because we get started.
Yeah.
That defense is wild, y'all. It's ridiculous how that...
You have nothing.
Yeah, they have nothing.
And they have no options either on the bench.
No.
Umtiti... I'd prefer Umtiti, but he's still... I don't know, man. He's just, like, so weird.
I remember when I first started watching him play. I liked how he played. He played well.
Yeah, he would anticipate pretty good. And he was kind of quick. But I don't know. I think it's just contagious. I think, like, Piqué just... started, I don't know, hanging out with the other defense more.
It's probably a really shitty mood at the camp.
Yeah, heck yeah.
It probably sucks. It's probably like going to a job you fucking hate.
Yeah, and it's like you have Messi there, and you're like, oh, Messi. And Messi's probably like, God damn it, I fucking hate my job now.
Motherfucker's still here, damn.
And then Coleman was like, that's what happens when you talk before the match, too. He was like, I could see Barcelona winning the Champions League. There's not that much teams that are better than Barcelona at the moment. And boom, 4-1.
And home.
Home, 4-1.
I don't know. I mean, but yeah. Nah. I mean, that's the match that we definitely had to talk about. And other matches were close calls. And
nah, like, yeah. We also got the Sevilla match. I got the Sevilla match wrong. I said Sevilla was going to win, and they lost.
Well. Haaland.
Haaland stepped up his game as well.
Yep.
And then Juventus-Porto. That was I got that one right.
Yeah, we got that one right.
I said 2-0, but like, they got a lucky going.
I was pretty lucky. At least Ronaldo didn't score.
At least.
Mr. Champions. ¿Qué pasó con Mr. Champions?
Let's see what he does for the second leg.
He's about to turn up.
I don't know.
Hopefully they don't call like 2 or 3 penalties in the second leg.
I don't know.
But he won or bounced at the last second, though.
Yeah. Yeah, and he was mad the worst part. Man. He was mad. I understand. Yeah, maybe I'll try to cheat my way. Maybe. Yeah, maybe I'll dive. Maybe they'll give me the penalty. But not dive and get mad on top of that. I mean, how the fuck are you going to get mad? There's fucking VAR, too. It's not just like the... And the referee waited first. He waited. They said it wasn't penalty. And then he ended the match. And then they go still mad.
They should have just, like, ended the match and then let him take a penalty. Just so he can just, like... Just shut up already. Like, just doesn't count as a goal. That's it. That's it. That's all he wants. Thank you so much.
God damn it, yo. Yeah, I mean, that's it for Champions League. Definitely these matches this week are pretty good, too. Pretty good matches. Definitely looking forward for that quarterfinals. It's definitely going to be, like, the better teams.
Yeah, the draw. I want to see the draw.
Yeah.
Like, if City makes it, I want to see who they get, if they make it.
You're probably hoping for... Watch Barcelona make it. If Barcelona makes it, I'm chopping off Andy's nuts.
Like, if City were to possibly make it, I would like to face the Juventus or Porto.
Wait, what?
If City makes it, I would like to face either Juventus or Porto.
Juventus.
They're not that easy, watch.
Oh yeah.
I want City... Like, if Juventus make it, I want City to face Juventus. And I want to send bitch Ronaldo back to Italy.
I mean, you guys already played Porto in group stage.
Yeah, 3-1 home, 0-0 in Porto.
And then Juventus, no, they're just a slap. They're just old.
They came out of the same crap group as Barcelona. That's why both those teams they shouldn't have made it.
Yeah, and they had this other. What was the other team?
Ferencvárosi.
Some shit.
Some crap shit.
I don't know. And who was the other one?
Some other shit team.
Yeah, it was like,
damn, what was it?
I don't even remember.
It was a little bit better than the other team.
Yeah, though. Yeah, definitely.
Just the other team.
Yeah.
Nah, I can't remember what team it was.
But that's that. I mean, want to talk a little bit about Premier League?
Oh, of course.
Okay.
City with the 1-0. City. 1-0. 1-0. A win. Win away.
Yeah, we talked about that briefly. How City didn't play that good today. But they still won.
Yeah, because last week... We were like, City had Everton on Wednesday, and then they had Arsenal on Sunday, and now they have the Champions League match. Like, they've been having a lot of games, but they haven't like lacked like. 18. I'm scared when they're gonna lose. That's what I'm most scared about.
18 victories, 18 consecutive victories for all competitions, yep. For City.
13 in the Premier League.
The good thing about City is that when they have possession, they don't wear themselves out. Like, they make smart movements and they don't. They're not prone to injuries. Like, some players, they'll hold the ball too long, and that's when they get slide tackle, they get injured, whatever.
Only Aguero.
Yeah.
He's the only one.
Nah, De Bruyne. Good to God.
De Bruyne and Damien, más o menos, yeah.
Because he was holding the ball a little too long, and some motherfucker just comes around.
Yeah, definitely. But Liverpool lost for the fourth time home this season. It's 4 in a row.
So they haven't done that since 1923.
That is wild.
That's a long time ago.
That is wild. And there it is again. I mean, their defense is trash as well.
It's trash, man.
It's trash.
Their goalkeeper's trash.
Yeah, the goal. I've always said that. But here's the thing. I mean, like, their forwards are the same guys that won the Champions League. They're not scoring any goals anymore either.
They're not getting the penalties.
I also think it's because their center backs are lacking. Like, because that's what gave the wing backs like liberty to go up and put in some decent. They put some decent passes in. They crossed the ball well. Their fullbacks. So I think that's what they're lacking right now.
But they got Thiago. I thought Thiago was going to
win. That's what Rooney said. Rooney said that they were going to be the best team ever. For like 3 or 4 years, they're gonna win the Premier League.
I'll tag Rooney in this video, see if he...
This is the worst Liverpool team ever. It's the worst defending champions of the Premier League. So far, it's the worst.
So far, of course.
It's the worst one.
Yeah. They're sixth right now?
They're sixth, potentially eighth, if Everton and Aston Villa pick up points in their pending games. Eighth.
That's wild. That is wild. Liverpool, yeah, Liverpool's just...
Yeah, imagine them not in the next Champions League.
Damn. Yep.
Are they going to be the new United?
Most likely. No, they're just going to be the new... They're just going to go back to default settings.
The old Liverpool, yeah.
The old Liverpool for 30 years.
Wow, yeah. They were nobody for like so long.
Here, in 2050, you're going to hear Liverpool winning the league.
I mean, 2005, they had the Champions League, so... I guess that, but other than that, no.
They had a good run where they were the best team around, I think.
It's because they didn't pick up injuries that last year. I clearly remember that.
Champions League year? They won?
The Premier League year when they won it. The Champions League, you know how Champions League is. Like, you get a good run, you win it.
I think it's really hard to win the Premier League if you have like any injuries of your important players. Like, it's tough because it's just
you definitely need a long,
drawn-out season.
That's Liverpool. Like, Liverpool right now is suffering because...
Yes, you definitely need a good starting 11, and you also need a bench.
And City, even though they're first right now, they've picked up a lot of injuries this season.
And they're
still first.
I guess that's why you could say Leicester won it that year, because they were nobodies.
They didn't get any injury.
But they weren't playing Europa League. They weren't playing Champions League that year, obviously. They weren't.
Mm-hmm. That's a big factor.
You have to take that into account, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. So...
That's why I'm saying I'm worried about when City's going to lose. Like, I hope it's a Premier League match. Because Premier League's almost in the bag.
It's hard because even City, with their injuries, they still have a decent depth of squad. Like, there's nobody that's terrible.
Because at one point they're going to lose. They're going to lose again. Yeah, they're definitely not going to end this season undefeated. It's too many matches. I think it's like 20 matches left.
That's a lot.
Oh, definitely. All right, guys. Let's wrap this one up for today. We will be back next Sunday, definitely talking about this week's results of Champions League and analyzing a little bit each match. And then again, obviously, we'll be talking about Premier League, talking about the most important matches. And we have, like I said last week, eliminatorias coming up, so we're just going to wait on the list of players called up for international.
Hopefully they don't call any City players to their national teams.
Yeah, so definitely be talking about that when the time comes. And I guess that's it for today. This is APOL TV. I'm your host, APOL. I was here today with Lil D, Big B. And we also had a special intervention by Andy Getspunani. And hopefully he could... start watching a little bit of soccer so you could talk with us about these matches. And see you guys on the next one. Peace.
Later.